Welcome back. Oh. Yes. Wow.
It's Saturday. What's going on, everybody? It's your buddy, Mr. Maynard here. Oh, what an adventurous day. I'm a little tired. Sorry if I'm a little tired. But let's just say joined up with Ken's and Chris today, and we went out and hit the town. We hit every... We hit a couple stores today. We went to V-Stock. Then we drove out to Game Trader 2. Then we went out to Trading Games. And he bought... Well, it wasn't lunch. It was more like dinner, but we'll call it a dunch. And my belly's full. I just had a nap. Came home after eating that dinner. And boy, am I tired. At least we're playing Pokemon Snap tonight. And given that Pokemon Snap is pretty laid back, I should be okay. However, after Pokemon Snap, there's going to be a little demonstration of something to show you guys. Something I've been working with. What about Linner? Dunch or Linner. There's Brunch and Leckfast and Second Breakfast and Lunch and Toozies and Snacks. Dinner. I'm just rambling. I would say that Mr. Kins and Kreese had a really good day. He got mostly what he was looking for. He wanted to get a new OG Xbox, which he did. He got a whole bunch of his games that he loved to play when he was younger. I saw that he got... What did he get? He got a lot of Star Wars games. I know he's a huge Star Wars fanatic. And I saw him get Battlefront, KOTOR. He got a lot of good games. However, I got a couple games, some extras, just for today. I have a feeling Monday night will be another bonus run. Not set in stone yet, but a bonus run. And yes, Zero, we do need to go to Trading Games. Jason's a pretty cool dude, and his store is actually pretty awesome. A little side story right here. When I went there a couple days ago, when I was killing time, when I got down there, that's where I got my Extreme G, Extreme G2, and Glover. He pulled out an Extreme G cartridge and he goes, "Oh, that label looks like trash. Let me get you a better label." Guy really knows his stuff. I mean, if you're looking to make your loose carts into complete collections, he can help you. Guy has the boxes, the manuals, even the box inserts for spare if you need one. Which today, while I was there, I kind of did something for my Super Mario Bros. 3. I didn't have the little styrofoam block in there. I got a styrofoam block from him. A legit styrofoam block. So now my Mario Brothers 3 that's hung here in a shadow box is complete. Pretty awesome. He knows his stuff. He's told me he's been in the business for about 15 years. I suspect he's known it more. But either way, Jason's a totally cool dude. I need to go down there with my copy of In the Hunt for PlayStation 1 and get that thing mirror finished again, because it's really... Whoa. But I did get today, what did I get? I got a Perfect Dark. I finally have a physical of Perfect Dark. I've never owned Perfect Dark physical before in my life. So I finally will be able to sit down and play that. What else? I also got a very unique shooter, and people call it the poor man Metal Gear Solid. I got Windback. I got a copy of Windback for the N64. Even though there's PS2 versions, it's actually not bad on N64 from a lot of the reviews that I've seen. So I'm going to have to sit down and try that game out. I haven't actually played it. And then finally, I was able to snag a Metroid Prime, which I feel very good to have it now. Because it's like, I sit here and I have a Metroid Prime 2. But I did not have an original Metroid Prime. And the Metroid Prime that I got it, It's complete. It's complete in box. I feel great. I bet you he can, Zero. I bet you he can find the manuals and the insert for your Final Fantasy II. The insert, guaranteed, you can do that. I will tell you this. If you want to keep... Because I know you got some other games that you've got completed, if I can say one right now, if you like. Oh, what the hell. You have a Final Fantasy III that you have complete. If you want one of those plastic container things to keep your box clean and dust-free and all that, you can buy those there. And he doesn't even charge much for them. I snagged one today for my Mario Brothers 64 since it's complete. I think that sucker's worth, what, $45-$50 bucks now. And I went ahead and put it into a plastic box. If I go down there again, I'll make sure to take you with me because I'm going to go buy some other plastic protectors for some of the complete in-box games that I have. And if I need certain things, I'll make sure that they're complete. So a little investment. I wouldn't mind having some of my complete in-boxes protected and having their little styrofoam inserts if I need them. I think I need one styrofoam insert and a couple of plastic sleeves. That sounds about right. Okay. Pokemon Snap. I've been talking too long. What am I doing here? This came out in 1999. This is one game that I don't mind playing, but I do have a love-hate relationship with it because I was stupid when I was a kid. But this game came out in 1999. I had a friend of mine who we do a thing where we swapped games. I was an idiot and swapped like my Smash Brothers and crap for this because I thought it was so cool. When really... It was an okay game, but I should never have done that. I really should never have. So, now that I've gone back into recollecting games, I didn't give a crap when I bought this game for $1.50. And again, I had to spend $40 on getting a copy of Smash Brothers. That was not fun. Anyways, let's swap the cameras over, and yes, Mr. Zero, I will let you know if I do later this week. I might for the heck of it to help you out, so. Let's see here. Let's switch over to the Elgato. And I wonder if my cartridge is gonna work. Let me turn this sucker on. I knew it. It's not gonna want to cooperate. Ah, there we go. And everything is foobarred. Uh-oh, I think I know why. Hang on a second. Do-do-do-do.
Mama.
Oh, my camera doesn't want to cooperate with me. Hang on, we'll let the intro play out first. Oh, you think you saw the best Pokemon of all? You think you saw it, Todd?
Nope. Nobody will believe you.
So that was the intro. Hang on here. I'm going to switch back. See if I can get this working. USB device not recognized? What's wrong? Oh. We might not have camera tonight. Yep. No camera. We'll just, we'll have chat. We'll have that just in case. That's okay. Now you don't have to focus on my ugly mug while I play this. Because everybody loves my ugly mug. Oh, I forgot to also mention, thanks to Mr. Ken's increase, he bought me a legit Nintendo 64 controller pack. Not one of those generic ones. I have a legit one now. I have yet to still test it. I will put my Rumble Pack in. Check some settings. Yep, that's fine. We'll start a new game. What should we name our guy? I don't know how many characters we have. Oh, we can put in, I think, 8. So, let's just go ahead and put my name in. Nope, I can put 7 in, so I got it. Not ass. No ass tonight. Like, no ass that I ever get. Wah, 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 wah.
Hello there.
Right before the stream started, I was looking up things and noticed that supposedly now there's a theory that Professor Oak is supposedly a champion back in the Pokemon days. Reason I invited you here, Pokemon Report. Take photos. The 01 vehicle. No thank you. Oh, you try to trick me just like that stupid owl from Ocarina of Time, you little... Oh boy, I have to go through the tutorial. Really? I know how to take photos. Do I have to do this? Oh, too late. Is that a Pikachu? It is Pikachu. Butterfree, I choose you!
It's okay, Dylan.
Oh, there's an egg over there. What's that? Oh. Lapras. Damn you, Snorlax. Don't sit there. I need my apples. I need to throw apples at people. Yeah, little Meowf. Just like the voice actor. That's pretty cool. Meowf. That's right. Let's see here. See, if I had the apples, I could lure out the Pokemon from the grass. That, and I could throw apples in the river, and I can get a photo of a Magikarp. Magikarp. That's awesome. Oh, I forgot. I think they do a maneuver here. Yeah, there we go. I got them doing a move. I'm such a photographer. Let's see here. I want this one. Butterfree! I'm sorry, I just love that freaking cartoon. I might have a better score with... No. I think I'll have a better score with that one. Which one would be better? I think that one would be better. So basically what I'm doing here is I'm picking out photos for Professor Oak to look at. And he actually is going to score them. Yeah, we'll get the Meowth right there. And the Doduo. I think that'll be good enough. Yeah, let's show them these scores. Okay, here we go. So, what do we got? It's Pikachu. What's the size? So-so. Pose? 1,000. Alright. Technique? Right in the middle of the frame. Double score.
Wonderful.
Oh, not a bad shot. Alright, what do we got next? Butterfree. Size is okay. Pose is very nice. Oh, right in the middle of the frame. Alright.
Wonderful.
Not a bad shot. Oh, Meowth. Yeah. Yeah, the pose is okay.
Wonderful.
Oh, I didn't even say that I caught a Pidgey in the middle of that. What the hell? Okay, cool.
Wonderful.
Okay. There we go. Pidgey using Gust. Poses, eh. I get all that and only get... It's probably one of the lowest scoring pitchers. Oh, what's this? Other Pidgey in the pitcher. Okay.
Wonderful.
Okay, that's not bad. Wow, I actually scored like 15,000 in the first round.
Yeah.
Oh, the tunnel's open.
Yes.
All right, let's see what we can do on this one. So this sucks. I don't have those freaking Kakuna? Where'd he go? Ah, I didn't get a Kakuna. Oh well. Ah, there goes a Zubat. Totally missed the Zubat. I gotta be on my toes. Miss my Magikarp. God damn it.
Magikarp.
There's my Zubat. Don't even know what the heck that is. Well, without the apples, I really can't do much. I guess, yeah, that could be a Ghastly. Take a photo on. That was kind of a lousy run.
Eighteen pictures, okay.
Let's get that one. Yeah, can't do much without apples and balls. Okay, that's a pretty good picture of Pikachu. I'll give that a shot. Oh, it is a Haunter. Look at that. Okay, so, wait. We'll get that one just for, yeah, just so we can have it in our pictures. All right, let's see what Professor Oak's gonna say. Oh, an Electrode. Pretty decent. It's exploding. It's in the center. Wow, that's a pretty good score. How'd I get another one in the pitcher? Oh, 10 points. Thanks for giving my hopes up there, Professor Oak. Guess you're still banging Ash's mom. No wonder you sent him off on an adventure. Electrobuzz. Eh.
You were close.
Yeah, that's yeah. Yeah, this one's gonna be horrible too. Bit better. Oh. We'll save that one from the last report. Ah, Zubat.
Wonderful.
Okay, not bad. Ah, Haunter. Diglett.
Wonderful.
Not bad. Got an extra 15,000 on that round.
Wait.
Oh, return to the lab. What do you got?
Welcome back. Here is a present for you.
Oh, is there? Pokemon food. It's basically apples. Toss apples. No, don't repeat it. Let's go back to the beach. Yeah, I remember the Blockbusters kiosks that they have. I wonder if Jason's got one.
Yes.
Those were pretty cool back in the day. All right, now we have the apples. So now we can do this. You can smack things with the apple. Oh, did I wake him up? Come on, wake up. Ah, damn it. That's right, I do need to lure Pikachu to the surfboard. Right, there's gonna be a Pidgey coming out here. And then I just hit the Meowth. Nothing? Ah, boy. Oh, give me one more. Ah, shit. There we go, got the Chansey. Genghis Khan. You get that, Meowth. Got him. All right, let's see here. Let's try that one. Chansey. Let's see here. Trying to debate which is going to be the better Magikarp. This one. Sadly.
Yes.
Alright, let's see what we can do here. Bigger size, lower pose.
Well,
there we go. There we go.
Well done.
Not bad. The stream cut out again? No drop. I don't know what the heck is going on. Really? Okay, I can take that. 2,900 points. Magikarp.
Magikarp.
Oh, that'll help. Oh, a hidden path in the tunnel?
Welcome back.
I'm gonna go to the beach again.
Yes.
I'm gonna lure that Pikachu to do the surf. Sorry, Chew. Come on. I wonder if that'll count. There we go. Surfing Pikachu. Oh. Very lively. Oh yeah. That's a 5,000 point score. Not bad. Okay, I feel better getting that photo.
Welcome back.
Tunnel. Vape Nishal. Just gonna bonk this electrode. Where are you going? Kuna. All right, better Electrobuzz pitcher. Boy, he's not happy. It's like I'm trying to concentrate on taking photos. It's like, ah!
Mother of God.
Just that look on Todd's face. Mother of God. Thirteen pitchers. that one. That's actually a pretty good Magikarp. That's a better Haunter. Okay, that should be good.
Yes.
So-so, that's a pretty damn good photo. Perfect.
Wow.
Oh great, an extra 20 points. Thanks, Professor Oak.
Well done.
Much better.
Magikarp.
Much better. Okay. Just a little more. That's not bad. Okay. A little more. Not bad. Oh, that's a better picture. Okay, we'll take that. Oh, this is a biggie.
Wonderful.
Not bad.
Wait.
Oh, return to the lab? Okay.
Welcome back.
Yeah.
The volcano. Let's go.
Yes.
Okay, let's see. That was a cool rapid dash. Is that a Vulpix? It's a Vulpix. I see Charmanders and a Magmar. Okay, perfect. Trees.
Bug ball.
Now he's running around, that's funny. And a Magikarp, just for the heck of it. I think I got a really good shot of Moltres. Oh, that's a good shot. A shot of rapid dash. That should bring in a lot of points there. Yep, that'll do. Oh yeah, that'll do. Alright, let's see how this worked.
Yes.
A Rapidash. Okay, pretty good. Not bad. Right in the middle. Nice. And another Pokemon in the background. Thanks for the 10 points there. I picked that Magmar shot because it had a technique in it.
Wonderful.
See? 1200 points for the pose. See? Not bad.
Wonderful.
Moltres. Pretty decently sized. Great pose. Right in the middle.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Yeah, baby, yeah. Oh, look, I'm not even looking. I'm not even looking.
Wonderful.
30-20. Okay. Oh, back to the lab we go.
Welcome back.
Ah, the river.
Yes.
I wonder what we'll see on the river. I'm on a boat. Is that a Bulbasaur? Got it. Bulbasaur! Wait.
Slowpoke. Slowpoke. Slowpoke.
Oh, I've got to lure them over there so they can evolve. Come on, Psyduck. Quit screwing around. Let's go. There we go. There was something there on the wall. That's what I'm saying, flying shelters. Sorry, Pikachu. There's another pathway over there. Only 7 photos. That. That. Actually, this one might be my... yeah, that might be my best one. Okay, I'll take the picture.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
You were close.
Oh, really?
Wait. Welcome back.
Pester ball. Alright, so now we can go to the start again and use the pester ball to start pestering them. Get a better photo of that. Wake up, Snorlax. You little shit. There we go, got a Scyther. Come on. Ah, I didn't get a good photo of that. That's okay. A dancing Meowth. There we go. That made my day. That should be a better shot. Snorlax. Scyther. Kangaskhan. I'm gonna go for this Meowth. Nah, you know what? This one. Let's see what happens.
Wow.
Better size. Ooh. Nope. Save that one.
Wonderful.
All right. Better size. Better good pose. Technique. All right. Much better score. Oh, there we go.
Wonderful.
Not bad.
You were close.
I got 40 extra points.
Better size. Angry pose. Good technique.
Well done.
Ooh, excuse me. Do the tunnel.
Yes.
Pester some things in the tunnel. Magikarp.
Hey, thanks for the host there, Zero. Come on, Electrobuzz. I don't think I'm gonna get a better Magikarp photo. Alright, see what he thinks of these four. Yeah, that wasn't worth it. I'll keep the last one. Oh, there we go. A little extra points. Meh. Well, I tried.
Welcome back.
Yes.
To the volcano we go.
Try that Charmeleon with evolution. Crap, there were like four Charmanders back there. Come here, you little shit. Almost the same exact shot. That's crazy. Alright, Professor Oak, what you got? Nah, not worth it. Better size. Awesome pose. Better technique, and the same Pokemon with an extra 440 on it. That wasn't bad. I tried. Save that one. Yeah, we'll save the old one.
Wow.
A fighting Magmar. Pretty good size. Yep. And another Magmar. Damn, that was a big photo. We're gonna go to the volcano one more time because I'm gonna get all those Charmanders.
Yes.
Go, my Vulpix friends. Oh, I think I know what I gotta do with that. I gotta convince all three of them to go over there. Already seen the Moltres, we're good. I think I just remembered something. Oh, hello there, Nuvaria. Yeah, knock the Charmeleon in the lava. I just remembered that. That's a pretty good photo.
Yes.
See what I got. Ooh.
Well,
a little extra, not bad. No. Save that one. One more run in the lava.
Yes.
Ah, that's what I get for not paying attention. Damn it. We need to lure our little Vulpix over.
Come on.
They're all getting bonked. It's like, come on, guys. Over here. Over here. Over here. Over here. Over here. All right, good photo. All right, Charmeleon, we're gonna do this. Got him. That's a big freaking Charizard. Okay, we're done. We can leave the course. All right, Novaria. Catch you later, man.
Yes.
Not enough. I'll save that old one. Better size. Pose is awesome. Technique is good. And more Pokemon in it. Yeah!
Well,
there we go.
Well,
a little bit better. Time to go to the river.
Welcome back.
Now we can use that pester ball. Piss off some Pokemon.
Thank you.
Slowbro.
Wake up.
Slowbro. Slowbro.
So get out of here. Cloister. Aha! Uh-oh. Ah, okay, we're good, we're good. Not gonna be a good photo, but at least I get it in there. Just by a hair.
You were close.
You were close. Yeah, thanks. Thanks, Professor Oz. Wait. Oh, back to the lab.
Welcome back.
Yeah. Through the cave.
Yes.
Wait a minute. Aha. Knew something was funny there.
Oh,
Bell, 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 bell.
Come on. Oh no, Pikachu! Let him go! Yep, I can't get him. Yeah, I was like, wait a minute, those don't look like Bulbasaurs. And then I hit it with that ball. I'm like, yeah, that was a ditto. I knew it. Fucking fake. That one I'll get a good photo. I think that's the best we got. Waste of time. Keep that one. Oh, wow. Wonderful. That was a horrible shot, and I somehow got 2,400 points on it.
You were close.
Eh.
Wonderful.
Not bad.
Wow.
Jigglypuff on stage. Not bad. Three more Pokemon pitchers. Okay.
Welcome back.
Well, if I take the river, I know there was here one here that I need to get. There's two of them actually.
Slowbro.
Gotta wake this bastard up. Wake up. Don't say to your girlfriend.
Poke.
I got two. I need one more. Sucked. Keep the old one.
Well done.
Much better. Porygon.
Wonderful.
I need one more Pokemon. Try the tunnel. I'm gonna see if I can get that Dugtrio. How do I get that egg to hatch? There's some way you can actually get this working. You see something in the shadow. There you go, got a Magmite. Try these out. Keep the old one. Keep the old one. There we go. Oh, there we go.
Wonderful. Wait.
Oh, what do we got in the lab?
Welcome back.
Yeah.
The valley. Okay.
Yes.
Come on, Gia, dude. Boy, that sand shrew was happy. Well, that was a waste. Oh, that was funny. Hiya. What's this?
Oh.
Alright, so now I gotta take pictures of the statues. Horrible photo, but I'm gonna take it.
Yes.
Hmm.
Wonderful. 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 You were close. Wonderful.
60 points. Thanks again, Professor Oak.
You were close. Wait. Welcome back.
Oh, there we go. Signs. I've seen that one, and I've seen that one. I don't know where the others are. We're gonna have to look. Now this is pod racing. Wow, it's already... we're almost down to our last 20 minutes. All the signs... Pokey flute. All right, let's see if we can use the pokey flute. Out of my way, Electric Buzz. I don't need you.
Hmm.
Got it. That'll help. There we go. There's another one. Let's see here. We want that. We want this. Zapdos. Sign. Okay. Surfing Pikachu is not going to get beaten.
Wait.
You mean it's not in the middle? It is in the fucking middle.
Oh, wonderful.
Professor Oak, you're a fucking prick. Alright, let's see here. See what you can find in the volcano. Oh, son of a... It's right there at the start. Come along, my Pokemon friends. I already got your Moltres, fuck off. It's like you see the Pokemon you don't need, and there's one behind it. You just shove that Pokemon out of the way. I don't need a picture of you. I've already got you.
Yes.
Oh, wonderful.
Cool. Three to go.
Welcome back.
What's the next one? Is it a Cubone if I remember? Yeah, Cubone. Tree near the river or the jungle that looks like a Cubone. Nobody knows where who planted it, but I've seen or heard someone has seen the tree.
Okay. So mainly these runs, it's just boost through and then find where these signs are. Let's see here. If I was a tree that was like a Cubone, where would I be? I got an idea. Right there. Psyduck, what are you doing, buddy? You better run. Run, motherfucker, run! Two more signs, that's all we need. And I already know where the last sign's at. It's at the beginning of the valley stage. So where is this photo next that I gotta look for? I think it's a Mewtwo photo. That. That. Let's see if I can get a better score on that one. Not bad. Yep. The old one was better.
Oh.
There's what? Your sign.
Welcome back.
Okay, I gotta find this sign. Shining brightly somewhere. Where the hell is this gonna be in the cave?
Yes.
Leave him alone. Come on. There we go. Did that wrong. think that was the sign right there. Jinx is racist. What if I did this? Oh, damn, I pissed off Jigglypuff. All right, let's see here. Aha, yes. I did get it. Let me get that one. There's the sign. Articuno. A better Jinx. And a pissed off Jigglypuff. This was the best trip ever. Better pose, better technique, same Pokemon. Good shot.
You were close.
Why, hello there, Cherry. You finally showed up. There's your sign.
Wonderful.
Oh, that's okay. If you were out, that's fine. I've been having fun here playing Pokemon Snap. Oh, you just got back? Did you go grocery shopping? Do you have to go cleaning? Alright, Valley. We just gotta get one more of these Pokemon signs, and we're good. There it is. We're done.
Yes.
Here you go, Oak. Here's that picture.
Oh, wonderful.
Professor Oak was your first husbando. I hate to say this, but he's already hitting Ash's mom. He was hitting Ash's mom because she was a MILF. Alright, guys. Rainbow Cloud. What could we get here? Oh my. Get this shot. Oh, there goes the shield. Come on, Mew. Oh, where'd you go? Oh, now you're gonna move around. This is like the boss. Start the whole game over. Really? I gotta start the whole game over? Alright, shield off.
You heard me, bitch. Come on. Come on. I gotta get that one in a million shot. Perfect. Got it. Thanks, Mew. Bye-bye.
Eat the goddamn apple. Eat the candy. Eat the fucking candy. Eat the fucking candy. Drink the fucking soda. Drink the fucking soda.
Got it. There you go, Oak. I just got the rarest Pokemon of all time. Wow. Wonderful. Thanks, Oak. Wait.
Welcome back. You made it. See you.
And that, my friends, is it. That's Pokemon Snap. Pretty much you work your way up to get a photo of Mew, is what you do. I'll tell you what, if Niantic wants to do something like that, they should make a Pokemon Go Snap, where the objective is to take photos of Pokemon as best as you can. That is a fucking gold mine. How cool would that be, though? Playing Pokemon Snap Go, or Pokemon Go Snap? I'd play it. And others. Gee, that looks like they just didn't have enough time. Yeah, it would require some advanced models. Although the models that they have already is pretty decent. It'd be a little difficult. People getting hit by cars, yeah, I could see that. I could definitely see that. Or people getting into car accidents for not paying attention while they're driving. Yay. Okay, so that's the end of Pokemon Snap, but there's a little more. I've got a little bonus part here for you. So give me a second here. I'm going to get everything all set up. So I'm going to take a small break, and we're going to swap games over. So I'll be right back.
Okay, I've got everything all set up now. So, real quick, you're probably wondering, why are we playing F-Zero X? Even though it is a really good game. And it is a technological advancement or achievement for the Nintendo 64. It's one of the only few games on the Nintendo 64 to have 60 frames per second. Especially since you have 30 other racers total. You have 30 racers total on the track. So, a couple weeks ago, I was hanging out with Kenz and Kreese, and we have been working. Well, first off, he wanted to get a whole bunch of translated games for his Super Nintendo. So, long story short, while exploring, I found out that there is a way to play the F-Zero X expansion kit on an Everdrive 64. And let me tell you, kind of glad I can play this, because let me just tell you something real quick. If you go to eBay right now and look up F-Zero X expansion kit, the game itself is going between $100 to $200. $100 for just for the disc, up to $200 for a sealed copy. Or if at least you want one that's complete, you're looking between $120 and $170. It's ridiculously expensive. And that does not include the 64DD. The 64DD, I'm looking at prices right now at this, and it's, oh my god. Let's see here. There's one here for $1,500, $600, $1,800. It is ridiculously expensive. $1,300. Just crazy. Just crazy. But luckily enough, with a firmware change and an update, you could actually play the 64DD games. You can play some of them, but not all of them. Luckily, there's like three translated games. The F-Zero X expansion kit is fully English translated, which is awesome. Unfortunately, there is a SimCity, and there was another game as well, too, but I never got around to it. Those are slightly translated, but there's one little downfall about the 64DD version of F-Zero X. You can't save, which kind of sucks. So, if you have this, you have to keep it on. So, alright, let me get this going here. I'm going to swap over the camera. Screen capture. Oh, no. Elgato. The Elgato. So I'll just show you guys a nice little demonstration of this. This is actually really cool. And doot doot. So I've already got my file here ready to go. It's going to load up. It's going to load up like a normal ROM from your Everdrive 64. I'm going to switch over to my earbuds again. And there you go. That's all it is. So let me press start here. Let's see here. OCR up, down, up, right. Okay. Luckily, there is a cheat for F-Zero X and 64WD version. You put that code in and it unlocks everything. That's okay. So you don't have to keep your system on if you just want to play it. However, this is the version that's superior. So let me show you a little thing here real quick. So here's a course edit. You can make your own courses. Have not attempted to do this, because this is ridiculous. Let's see here. Yeah. So 3D plane. So it's like really technical. I can't do it. However, there are some other options. You can create your own machine. So now we have our own way of making our own F-Zero X vehicle. So let me make one real quick. We'll use this cockpit. I like this setup and this. Okay. That. You can change your settings. Hey, you can't keep them all A's, so watch this. If I do an A body, an A boost, I can only take an E grip. So it'd be a really bad drifting machine. So I do this. I do A body, C boost, B grip. Pretty good. Save that. We'll call it Rad. And then we can use it. There's other ones on here like Super Machines, but I haven't gotten around to using them yet. So we'll just use Rad. And you just take over a pilot. We'll take over the Red Gazelles. That's it. So now I can actually use that machine. Everything else is pretty much the same. However, you also get two extra cups. You get the DD cups. DD cups. Those are massively nice. But we're going to have a little fun here. We're going to do a time attack. We're going to go to Joker Cup. And we're going to drive on Rainbow Road. Now, this is on the original 64 version, but there's a twist with this one. We'll use my gun. We'll use Rad here with the Mighty Gazelle. And everything else just plays the same. Just listen. An F-Zero-X remix of Rainbow Road. How cool is this? And driving one of my own vehicles. I was so happy to get this working because I've always was interested about this when I heard about it back when it came out. And I was in grade school when this came out. No, I'm just realizing that the rumble feature is working too. That's awesome. If anybody wants to know the question, no, you cannot do the shortcut jump on this course. It would consider a drop, a kill. So I'll get that out of the way right now. You can't do it. For what it takes to do three laps on this, takes almost about one lap of Mario Kart 64. That's fine. Oh. So how cool is that, guys? I love my Everdrive. Oh yeah. So just for fun, let's go to a GP race. Let's do one of the DD races. So here's Silence 3. It's an outside loop. The soundtrack of this game is also expanded. There's more tracks of music. You heard one track while we were waiting. It's this track. So there's more courses, and then if this was able to save, which they are working on the firmware to do that, and even Chris is giving a hand to get this to work. Once it gets working, oh man, the course ideas are just endless. Oh, you just... Whoa, where'd he go? Did he fall off? Nope, he didn't fall off. We're good. So if you never played F-Zero X, I mean, it's just a futuristic racer. It can get difficult to play. Like that. I wasn't paying attention. Great. Because it had that outside loop. It just literally went, whoop, out of here. See ya. Alright, try it again. Now, I would like to bring something up that one of the channels that I watch, Metal Jesus Rocks, he actually has in possession what could be a US version of the 64DD. And supposedly he's got a disc with it, but they don't know what's on the disc. They don't know what the contents are. He was supposed to find out on Friday, and hopefully he'll have a video very soon of what's on it. I'm kind of excited to see what it is. Kind of sucks though. I mean, we had an event here where we could have had some extra stuff with games, because this was going to be used. The 64DD was going to be used for a lot of games, but the development for it was just too much, and they dropped it. Heck, there was supposed to be an Earthbound on the DD, and they took that idea. They took the story ideas and put it towards just three. Whoa! That was a bit much. Never mind. Let me show you some courses. This is Big Blue 3. This is called Japan. It's in the shape of Japan. But let me tell you right now, this course is crazy. I've only raced this course like 2 times. It even has its own theme. Like, holy crap. As skilled as I am for this game, this course is just unbelievable. Too many sharp turns. Very close, narrow pathways. Mine's great. And you get turns like that. Oh god, that jump. This course is stupid. I would love to see this get used for some tournament that we're going to have down the road for St. Louis Retro Gamers. This would be hilarious. Because guaranteed, pretty much nobody has ever played this. I would step back and watch and see what happens. Come on. Oh god, those jumps. I hate those jumps. Thank you. Almost done here. To be fair, another 3DD got scrapped for a multitude of reasons, including the DD driving, the dev team not working well 3D.
That is true. That is very true.
Show you guys here a couple more tracks. Some of these ridiculous tracks. Mute City 4 with the slim half pipe. The Bigfoot, very deadly curves. Well, Firefield 2 has a 180 degree rollover. Holy crap. Trap Road, straight jumps. Let's try Mute City 4. Never raced this course, and I'm already not liking it. Oh, now it's getting worse. Screw this. Oh my god. Oh, I am clenching a little. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Puppies, where are the puppies? This reminds me of like Stunt Race FX on the Marina's tracks. The stupid half pipe tracks. I hate those. That's a series that needs to come back. Nintendo needs to look at that IP. They can bring it back and keep it graphically how it looked like and improve on it. Like, still make it polygonal. With the Super FX looks, you know, with just flat shades of color. Yeah, bring that back. Add more cars, or even make your own cars, and make a ton of courses. And then include online racing. I'd be happy. Maybe it'll be an NX exclusive. I am curious of what the NX is going to be. I am a little mad that I just got a Wii U earlier this year, and now the NX is going to be coming out. But, oh well, I mean, Wii U will stay in my collection. So either way, guys, that's the little demonstration I wanted to show you. That, and the F-Zero X 64 Double D, which is kind of like the nickname for it, but the F-Zero X expansion kit works with an Everdrive 64. I'm not sure if it works on version 1, but it's been confirmed to work with version 2 and version 3. However, again, you cannot save data with this. Kind of sucks. So, alright. What an interesting night. We actually beat Pokemon Snap. Well, friends, I think that's the end of the stream for tonight. A little tired. No, I'm not a little tired. I'm really tired. I will be back tomorrow evening, and we will be taking on Mystical Ninja starring Goemon. So everybody know their lyrics to the Impact song, because we might be singing it. I'm debating if we could finally get a donation for this channel. If we get like a small donation, I might sing the song. Sure enough, maybe we'll have some fun here
And maybe I can get a hold of Kinzen Craze and see if he'll sing it too. So, because he's a huge fan of Mystical Ninja. I am too, but he likes the 64 version, especially Impact's theme. So, we've got that, and then I'm debating on Monday with a bonus stream, which we may do a stream with some games that I gotten recently. We'll see how that goes. And then Tuesday will be our finale. It'll be our... What is it? What were we going to play? Sin and Punishment. That's right. English version of Sin and Punishment on my Everdrive, which should be very good because that's a treasure game. And treasure games are pretty damn good. I still have yet to sit down and play my Advanced Guardian Heroes, but it looks really weird. But hey, Guardian Heroes on the Saturn was freaking awesome. So, all right, everyone. I will see you tomorrow about... Oh, I'm debating if I'm going to be on at 7 o'clock or not. But we'll be on in the evening, and we will be playing Mystical Ninja, starring Goemon. So, till then, thank you everybody for coming in. Zero Shift, thanks for the host. Cherry Boomer, you're freaking awesome and a cutie. And I will catch you all tomorrow. Adios, everyone.